All right, we'll move on to our last team, and this would be the Atlanta Falcons. Obviously, lots to fix with them. They went 4-12 last year, got a ton of offensive weapons. Offense was not the problem with them last year. However, Dan Quinn fired, gone, out of here, adios, and they bring in Arthur Smith, the offensive coordinator from the Tennessee Titans, who has been with the Titans for, as long as I can remember. He has worked his way up from quality control up to tight ends coach, quality assistant, whatever it was, up to tight ends coach, up to offensive coordinator, blah, 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 blah. He's learned under a lot of different people. He can meld old school with new school. I like the fact that he is a guy that didn't have to work if he didn't really want to, and he goes out there and does this thing and has really worked hard at it. Chris calls him a problem solver. So we've got high hopes for Arthur Smith. The Falcons needed the list on here included quarterback. But it's basically everybody, quarterback, safety, running back, cornerback, and guard. We'll roll through the picks here. They got, we think, the best overall player in the draft, and I think that might be over Trevor Lawrence at number 4, tight end Kyle Pitts out of Florida. Second round, safety, Richie Grant out of Central Florida. Offensive tackle, Jalen Mayfield out of Michigan in the 3rd. Cornerback, Darren Hall out of San Diego State, who was a steal to me. I don't know what the rankings had him, but he's fantastic at San Diego State. Center Drew Dahlman out of Stanford in the 4th round. 5th round, they got interior defensive lineman Taquan Graham out of Texas. Edge rusher Adetokunbo Ogundeji. Ogundeji out of Notre Dame.
Just call him AO.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
We let Gary do that, Kyle.
Yeah, I don't do that shit. No.
Round 5, Avery Williams, cornerback out of Boise State. And then wide receiver Frank Darby out of Arizona State in the 6th round. Overall, I was kind of a fan of this draft.
Me too.
You know, it's not great, but you bring in somebody like Kyle Pitts. I think Richie Grant was awesome. He's another one of those guys that wasn't highly recruited out of high school. He came in as a 165-pound wide receiver and left as a 200-pound safety. He switched positions. It looked great under that regime there. They didn't have a ton of defensive, playmakers, and he was a boss on that team. Offensive tackle Jalen Mayfield out of Michigan I thought was great. I think overall they got some pretty good dudes, and they took some flyers on guys that are talented, maybe didn't produce at the highest level in college. But this is what the Falcons needed. Take as many bites of the apple as you can and see what you got, right? They didn't hit every need. If one of your needs is running back, you can go out and get an undrafted guy and figure it out.
They signed Mike Davis. They signed Mike Davis, who's a huge upgrade over Todd Gurley. Massive. Basically, Todd Gurley is me in the backfield. He's about as fast as I am and about as durable as I would be as well. I would be dead, and that's basically what Todd Gurley is. But I like what the Falcons did here. So their offense, you're right, wasn't necessarily a problem, but it was on occasion because you knew every week you were going to get Julio Jones questionable. And if he went out in the first quarter – I love to bet Falcons team totals last year, getting them at 20.5, 21.5. And if Julio Jones went out in the first quarter, guess what? You're not getting the team total. Matt Ryan falls apart, and that's just how it was. And they had no running game to rely on either. Bringing in Kyle Pitts gives you – look, he's not Julio Jones, obviously, but he's this matchup problem. He's this guy Matt Ryan can go to when he's in trouble like he likes to do with Julio Jones. So now when we see Julio Jones questionable 16, 17 straight weeks next year, he's going to have a guy opposite of Calvin Ridley and Kyle Pitts who can get things done. I think you're absolutely right. He was the best prospect in this draft. He and Trevor Lawrence were right up there neck and neck. So I really like what the Falcons did. And then they started to build, add some secondary help, add some help on the offensive line, get some defensive tackles in the field. I like what they did here. Remember, that Falcons defense was really, really bad to start the year. Once Raheem Morris took over, the Falcons defense got much, much better. I like what the Falcons did. Probably in this division outside of Tampa Bay, because it's hard to hate it when they're all luxury picks. I think this was the best draft in the division. I like what the Falcons did. I think Kyle Pitts is going to have a massive, massive year with the Falcons.
Yeah, I'm with you. This just could be just a huge homage to Kyle Pitts and what he is. We think of tight ends, and we think of guys like Kelce, and we like the great tight ends, like the catching tight ends. We think of Kelce, and we think of Kittle, and we think of Gronk. Kyle Pitts is more athletic than all three of those guys. Okay, he's going to he's not only going to open up the red zone for Atlanta, which they're terrible at, by the way. This is a team that just blasts field goal after field goal after field goal in the red zone. they score a lot. They don't punt a lot, but they can't punch it in all the time. He's going to solve that problem. He's also, because of his athleticism, because of his speed, because of his size, he's going to be able to stretch the field like those other tight ends can't do. He's going to be able to run away from guys, okay? And that, I think, is going to give them another weapon, because outside of Ridley, nobody on that team has been able to run away from guys. Now, I'm not saying he's running away from the best cornerback in football, but any linebacker that's going to try and cover him, he's running away from them. And most there safeties. Are some safeties and cornerbacks that he can run away with.
Well, I mean, if you look at him, like Darren Waller yeah, for the Raiders. Well, imagine what he does for that team.
Yeah.
I think Pitts is much more athletic. If you look at Pitts' size and everything, he is much more Megatron than he is a tight end. Vernon Davis.
He doesn't have DK speed, but he's going to play the game a lot like DK.
I mean, he did clock it like a 4.36, wasn't it? I mean, it was crazy that, numbers.
Listen, DK just ran like 10.6 in the 100, okay?
Yeah, he was, 10.37 in 100?
Yeah, 10.47. Yeah, he ain't doing that, all right?
Probably not.
Did you see that race, too? DK was four times the size of every other
everybody,
person.
And he was right there with them. I know he finished ninth out of nine, but he was right there with them.
Yes, he was.
I'm so proud of him for doing that. I'm so the balls it took to do that, too, man.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
It was awesome. Right. It was awesome. So, yeah,
I like
Kyle
this draft. I like what this team did.
Yeah.
But I'll tell you this, the end result. I think this team's going to look a lot like the Cowboys last year. They're going to put up 45 points. They're going to lose 48-45 a lot.
Yep.
Yeah, I tend to agree
until
with
they
that.
Can figure out to stop somebody. I think that's going to be a problem.
When they went and got two cornerbacks, they helped their offensive line with Jalen Mayfield. They needed safety help, defensive back help. They certainly got that with Richie Grant. Like I like everything about this, man. Like they seem to do a pretty good job.
This draft wasn't the place to go fix their front seven, but I'm not a fan of their front seven, and that's the problem.
Oh no,
there's not a cornerback in the league that if Tom Brady has 5 minutes to stand back there and throw the football, he's eating you. You're losing every one of those games 100%. Sam Darnold's awful, but Sam Darnold might be able to pick you apart if he's got 30 seconds to stand back there, okay? You've got to be able to get rush, and the front seven does that. I don't think they can. I don't know how they solve that.
Definitely not with the draft right now. But
well, no, not this this year's draft was not the place to solve that. So.
Yep. Right. But obviously this coming year, who knows? Like, might end up a little bit better. You might end up with a decent draft pick. You might. Yeah, who knows what we can expect out of them? But you never know. But there's still free agency. There's still stuff going on. But I like what they started with here. This is just the beginning. They had a lot of picks. I'm always a fan of a lot of picks, and they certainly took some guys that I'm a fan of. So I think I think that's gonna wrap up today's show. What do you guys want to do for Tuesday? You want to do what, the West, maybe? NFC and AFC West?
Let's do the West.
We'll do the West tomorrow. We'll do the North on Wednesday, and we'll do the East so that we can wait all the way until Thursday for Chris to talk about his Patriots.
Perfect. I'm not ready to hear that crap yet. I'm not ready to hear all this Patriot love nonsense. Not ready for it.
I can understand it. All right, let's go ahead and get out of here. You guys go to winningcureseverything.com. Go to sbrpicks.com/NCAAF. And for you, Kyle, it would be sbrpicks.com/NFL or /MLB. And do you have a DFS Bachelor website or just the YouTube?
No, just the YouTube. I keep meaning to build a website, but I'm really dumb at those things. And my son should do it, but then he just gets pissed off at me and we fight about it. So I don't know. Let's go to the damn YouTube channel for now.
There you go. DFS Bachelor on YouTube. You can also find it on Twitter, as you see on the screen here, @DFS Bachelor. Kyle, we can't thank you enough. We are going to do this again for 3 days straight. So hopefully you will join us. If you have not already, make sure and hit subscribe and join us again on Tuesday, and we will get this thing knocked out. All right, fellas, take care of yourself, take care of each other, and hopefully all your tickets cash this week. Thanks for checking out Winning Cures Everything. If you want to keep up with us, hit subscribe on YouTube or your favorite podcast app. Visit the website at winningcureseverything.com, or you can like us on Facebook or follow us @WinningCures, @GaryWCE, or @ChrisBGiannini on Twitter. Share out the show, leave a nice review, and make sure to comment and tweet at us. Thanks for listening to the Winning Cures Everything podcast. The website is winningcureseverything.com, and if you want to connect with us, we're on Twitter @GaryWCE, @ChrisBGiannini, @WinningCures, or you can email us, Gary@winningcureseverything.com or Chris@winningcureseverything.com. Subscribe everywhere you need to subscribe, and we'll see you soon.